These are my friends. This is Gina. This is Lana. The other two are coming. And I guess I'm going to say something to Martin. I guess. To the door.
And Barb.
Here comes Deborah. Anyone want to say anything on Arcadia?
About they're taking pictures together and the sweet little note that Martin wrote for Susan
was
really special, and they look like they're very happy and calm and all ready for their day.
We are ready for this. So definitely ready for it. So to Martin, I'm so excited to be your wife, honey. I can't wait till this is done and we're in Jamaica. I can't wait to spend my life with you, and I love you with all my heart. So let's get the show on the
road. Just want to say hi, Susan, and I'm very happy to be marrying you today. Thank you for putting up with me. And let's see, I will see you in Jamaica, or be with you in Jamaica tomorrow morning. And just enjoy, and thank you for being with me. I'm glad I found you.
Thank you. come here together in the presence of God to witness and bless the joining together of this man and this woman in holy matrimony. The bond and covenant of marriage is established by God in creation. And our Lord Jesus Christ, during this matter of life, by his presence and first miracle at the wedding of Cana in Galilee, signifies to us the mystery of the union between Christ and his church, and Holy Scripture commends it to be honored among all people. The union of a husband and a wife, heart, body, and mind, is intended by God for their mutual joy, for the help and comfort given one another in prosperity and in adversity, and when it is God's will, for the procreation children and their nurture in the knowledge and the love of the Lord. Therefore, marriage is not to be entered into unadvisedly or lightly, but reverently, discreetly, and in accordance with the purpose for which it is intended by God. Into this holy union comes Martin Albert Rodriguez. And Susan will visit. Now, come to be joined. If any one of you can show just cause why they may not be lawfully married, speak now, or else hereafter forever hold your peace. I require in charge you both here in God's presence that if either of you know any reason why you may not be united in marriage lawfully, and in accordance with God's word, you do not confess it. Susan Elizabeth. We have this man to be your husband. We live together in a covenant of marriage. We love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him so long as you both shall live. Martin now. We have this woman to be your wife. We live together in a covenant of marriage. We love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others. Be faithful unto her so long as you both shall live.
Amen.
I address this to everyone here in this church, and I ask you all please respond to this question by answering we will. Will all do what you see each present promises, do all in your power to uphold these two persons in their marriage?
We will.
Who giveth this woman to be married to this man? Lord be with you. Let us pray. O gracious and ever living God, you created us male and female with thy image. Look mercifully upon this man and this woman who come to you seeking thy blessing and assist them with thy prayer. Keep them in thy promises and vows they made through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
Tonight I will be reading from 1 Corinthians 13. If I speak in the tongues of men and of angels, but have not love, I am only a resounding gong or a clanging cymbal. If I have the gift of prophecy and can fathom all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have a faith that can move mountains but have not love, I am nothing. If I give all I possess to the poor and surrender my body to the flames but have not love, I gain nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It is not rude, it's not self-seeking, it's not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not divide in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails. But where there are prophecies, they will cease. Where there are tongues, they will be still. Where there is knowledge, it will pass away. For we know in part, and we prophesy in part. But when perfection comes, the imperfect disappears. When I was a child, I talked like a child, I thought like a child, I reasoned like a child. When I became a man, I put childish ways behind me. Now we see but a poor reflection as in a mirror. Then we shall see face to face. I know in part, then I know fully, even as I am fully known. And now, these three remain, faith, hope, and love. The greatest of these is love.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ according to St. John. Father hath loved me, so I love you. Continue ye my love. If ye keep my commandments, ye shall abide in my love, even as I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love. These things have I spoken unto you, that your joy might remain in you, and that your joy might be full. This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Christ. This evening we're gathered together here in God's presence to witness a joining together of this man and this woman in holy matrimony. When St. Paul wrote his epistle to the Philippians, he said this: you have this treasure in earthen vessels. All of us carry the treasure of love in our hearts, in our minds, and in our souls. We are matter, we are flesh. And God has created us in his image. Each one of us is created in the image of the living God. Unfortunately, we don't always treat people that way. But if you listen to the lesson from St. Paul tonight from 1 Corinthians, and you heard the words of our Lord, the Gospel according to St. John, they're about love. And the love they're speaking of is agape. That is a Greek word that is used there in the New Testament. Agape means sacrifice. It means putting yourself last. When it was my joy to sit down with this fine young man and this beautiful young lady for marriage counseling, these two people have that. They already understood and knew what I was speaking of when we were talking about what love is. They know, in their own minds, in their own hearts, in their earthen vessels, that they carry this gift. The gift of love for God. And you should have heard them talk about their families. They know what it is to be joined together and be brought into this fight with parents who gave of themselves unselfishly and with great devotion to them as children, then as young people, and now as adults. The pride they spoke about, their mother and their father, their relatives, their brothers, their sisters. I wish all of you could have been there, because this young couple has a head start on many young couples that I married. And during my 41 years as a fiscal priest, I have married many, many families. But I want you to know now that God has blessed these two already because they have an insight which is rare. It's a gift. As St. Paul wrote, they carry this treasure in their earthen vessels, and their earthen vessels shall be joined together tonight as one. Two spirits, one completely in agape, in love for God, in love for each other, in love for their families, in love for you, in love in the work they will do when they too have a family and they are blessed also with children. And I hope and pray, because the kind of families they come from, that they'll have many of them. Take you, Susan Elizabeth, to be my wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better or for worse, for richer or for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, until we are parted by death. This is my solemn vow. In the name of God,
I, Susan Elizabeth,
take you, Martin Albert,
to
be my husband,
to have and to hold
from this day
forward,
for better or for worse,
for richer
or
for poorer,
in sickness and in health,
for love and to cherish,
until we are parted by death.
This is my solemn vow.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. Bless, O Lord, these rings to be a sign of the vows by which this man and this woman have bound themselves to each other, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Susan Kane, I give you this ring as a symbol of my vow. With all that I am and all that I have, I honor you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. I, Susan, give you this ring as a symbol of my vow. With all that I am and all that I have, I honor you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Now that Susan Elizabeth and Martin Albert have given themselves to each other with solemn vows, joining your hands and giving and receiving your rings, I pronounce that they are husband and wife in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Those who God has joined together, let no man put asunder. God, creator, preserver of all life, author of salvation, and giver of all grace, look with favor upon the world which thou hast made, and for which thy Son, Jesus Christ, gave his life, especially upon this man, Martin, and this woman, Susan, whom thou hast made one flesh, holy matrimony. Give them wisdom and devotion in ordering our common life, that each to the other may be a strength indeed, counsel in perplexity, comfort in sorrow, and companion in joy. Grant that their wills may be so knit together in thy will, and their spirits in thy Holy Spirit, that they will grow in love and peace with you all the days of their life. Give them thy grace, O God, if they hurt each other, to recognize and acknowledge their fault, seek each other's forgiveness and yours. Make their life together a sign of Christ's love to the sinful and broken world. Unity may overcome estrangement. Forgiveness heal guilt. Joy conquer despair. Restore them, O God, the gift and heritage of children, the grace to bring them up to know and love you and to serve you. Grant that the bonds of our common humanity by which all your children united one to another and the living to the dead may be so transformed by thy grace that your will may be done on earth as it is in heaven. Where, O Father, with your Son and the Holy Spirit, you live and reign in perfect unity, now and forever. Amen. God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, bless, preserve, and keep you. The Lord mercifully with his grace, that ye may so live together in this life, that in the world to come you will have life everlasting. Amen.
I promise not to doubt your judgments or actions without the assistance and feelings in your heart. I promise to support you in everything you try to accomplish, because your goals have become our goals, to achieve together side by side. I promise to look back on the good and bad times with a smile, to learn by each mistake, and know that with every step of success, we will make it if we just try. I promise to offer you all the happiness I am capable of giving you, to see that the future is ours to make the best of. I promise to set time aside to be best friends, to dream dreams, and make them reality, and just to say I love you. I promise most of all never to take it for granted, because you are the one I love.
Thank you.
Christ is risen, Christ will come again. We celebrate the memorial of our redemption, O Father, in the sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, recalling his death, resurrection, and ascension, and we offer you these gifts. Sanctify them with thy Holy Spirit to be for your people the body and blood of your Son, the holy food and drink of new and unending life in him. Sanctify us also, that we may faithfully receive this holy sacrament and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace. At the last day, bring us with all your saints to the joy of your eternal kingdom. All this we ask through your Son, Jesus Christ. By him and with him in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. Alleluia, Christ, our Passover sacrifice for us. Therefore, let us keep the feast, the gifts of God for the people of God. Take them in remembrance that Christ died for you, and feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving. Body of our Lord Jesus Christ, keep you in everlasting life. Amen. The body of our Lord Jesus Christ, keep you in everlasting life. Amen. The body of Christ, the bread of heaven. The body of our Lord Jesus Christ, keep you in everlasting life. Amen. The body of our Lord Jesus Christ, keep you in everlasting life. Body of Christ, the bread of heaven. The blood of Christ, the cup of salvation. The blood of Christ, the cup of salvation. The blood of Christ, the cup of salvation. Blood of Christ, the cup of salvation. The 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 blood of Christ. Let us pray. God, the giver of all that is true and lovely and gracious, we give thee hearty thanks for binding us together in these holy mysteries in the body and blood of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. Grant that by your Holy Spirit, Martin Albert and Susan Elizabeth, now joined together in holy matrimony, may become one in heart and soul, in mind and body, and live in love and fidelity and peace, and obtain these eternal joys, prepare for all who love thee, for the sake of thy Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Please kiss your wife. That was a good church kiss. Ladies and gentlemen of this congregation, It is my joy and pleasure to introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. Martin Albert Rodriguez. Would you greet them with your applause?
You're welcome. You kids gave me the sermon. I remember everything you said, didn't I? Huh?
Yes, you gave a great sermon.
Great, thanks.
Thank you.
You know what a sermon is?
And our one means no more hunting.
I see. What?
Today's opening day, and I can't go hunting. Next year's first anniversary, and I can't go hunting. But it'll change. But don't tell her that.
Webster.
In the months from September through January, is fishing, elk, and deer. You have to understand that. Thanks. Oh, I see.
I can't remember what I put in.
10:17 till the end of time.
Till the end of time. That's what I thought it said, but I was afraid if I said it.
Let's make this clear that next year I'll stay with her for Dennis hunting every October 17th.
Every other year?
I want to
see it all together.
I know. Are you?
No, hey, what? I tell you what, it's a good thing you brought that pillow in a blanket.
Here we go, I'll go check out the church.
Thank you.
Good job. Now look at the kid, look at Autumn. Get closer, right over there, and then shoot through the window.
I can't get in the car.
We're getting this on video.
I think that he's going to have to go the other way.
Yeah, that's
good.
I've known Martin since I was 5 or 6 years old. And I know his family moved in across the street. Across from Governor Sarda. My name's John Brady, and I'm here to toast Martin and Susan. I've known Martin since I was 5 or 6 years old, and when his family moved in next door to my family, I became part of their family, and Martin's like a brother to me. I've known Susan since I was a sophomore in high school, and I was there when Martin and Susan first met in biology class. That was 11 years ago. And now they're husband and wife, and I'd like to bless their marriage and wish them happiness. Thank you.
this time, we'd like to open.
When the night has come and the land is dark and the moon is the only light we'll see, no, I won't be afraid. Oh, I won't be afraid, just as long as you stand